baggage left. Let's go for that, eh?
You know, I'll be on my
shit, my shoes are soaking. What'd you drag me in here for?
Fuck's sake, get away. You told me, I'm telling.
I want to go for a swim. We went up to the footballs. Jesus Christ.
Shit. Shit.
Fuck's sake, you're only action, man.
Oi, where do you bastards think you're going?
Fucking none of your business, mate.
All right, you smart bastards. Get him! Come here, you parry! Hide him! Have a party, eh?
All right, boys. Let the residents get home.
Fucks!
What's that?
Fucking crap.
Jesus,
and a letter from Esther Lusty. She says, could you please mention my friend Lily Ferris?
Is your taxi fare?
And also may I...
And I want you home before 4 o'clock, because I want some messages done.
I can't. It's international. Can't go to Geraldine Murphy's to do her homework.
Sure, Lizzie Murphy told me that Geraldine was in bed all week with the mumps.
Could you also bring her some school books, haven't you?
Well, you can still be back by 4.
Geraldine, Alan, Helen, and all the rest.
Where did I put my school bag?
It's under the stairs where you left it last night. Jesus Christ, Tony, what happened to you?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? Tony! Tony! Do you hear me? I'll talk to you later, boy. Do you hear that? I'll talk to you later.
Jesus Christ, is that the time? Why don't you get me up before this?
You're staying up, pop there.
I'm not tired, do what I work.
Here, you forgot your lunch.
Right.
Oh, no.
Cheerio. Come on. You gonna go down there for me, eh?
Right, come on, girls. Hurry up. Girl, you're never gonna learn how to fix a tie.
It's all right.
It's not all right.
Okay. Watch yourselves now.
I don't know. Cheerio.
But what you're saying is exactly the opposite.
Sorry. I was playing devil's advocate.
Okay, the new angle. Sell it to me.
Well, I'm not quite sure yet how it'll work.
I like the idea of a 9-year-old's view of right and wrong.
Oh, that's
well, the age group will be exactly the same as in the other films. But the way I'm thinking is this, that the worse a situation gets, the more the rights and wrongs of that situation tend to get lost. Yeah. But, by keeping your head down, that doesn't mean that the sense of right and wrong gets lost, because that sense becomes part of how you survive and what you're surviving for.
Good, yes.
Now, I suspect, and I don't know what you feel about this, but I suspect that even in the most terrible circumstances, rather like those of a kid growing up in Northern Ireland since the trouble started, a keen sense of values remains, and it grows into anything, if anything, more strong than normal. And it's that that I want to look at.
Yes, you don't want to get too Orwellian, but it's a good angle. Go for it. You've got Sue McKenna over there, haven't you?
Yes.
And she's Irish herself, of course.
Yeah, well, she's not Irish. It's somewhere back in the family.
Well, the name should be going down all right with the right people.
No. The only thing that occurred to me, well, vaguely crossed my mind, was if she might not feel a bit too close to the subject. I mean, she's quite new, isn't she?
Oh, yes, she's new, but she's good. That's why I chose her. And she's very good at talking to people.
Fine, you're in charge.
You do have to be double careful of everything you're told over there.
Oh, don't worry. Eyes in the back of the head.
My old boss used to describe everyone he considered to be reliable as a sound man. It used to cause terrible confusion with the technicians, who all thought a sound man had to be someone wearing headphones. It's only love and hustle wonder why.
turns you reckon will lead us next week?
Monday sharp, I reckon. You all right for gear?
Yeah, I'll manage. I'll maybe get a couple of radio mics just to be on the safe side. Get them off out sell me up at UTV. Sure, I can charge them up to the beat, make up for the slave wages.
We should do okay. Straight 3-week shoot, mostly in Belfast. I'll sting them in the overtime.
That'll make a bit of a change from charging over every bog, filming the hero's funerals, won't it? What's this producer guy like, anyway?
Well, he's supposed to be a fella to watch out for. So Harry was saying, anyway.
In more ways than one. He's not bent, is he?
No, he always was, I suppose.
Hey, boy. What are you doing there? Come out here.
What do you want?
Sit down there. What have you been up to?
Nothing. I'm not up to anything.
Nothing? You call that nothing?
No, we're having to go to bed. We're getting our own back in the sores, that's all.
The stupid idiotie.
Look, they didn't get anybody, did they?
Get up the stairs. Get them clothes off you. And bring them back down to me. And get your face washed while you're up there. And listen. Tony, do you see this? This is just between us two. But so help me God, if I ever catch you doing anything like that again, I'll break every bone in your body. Do you hear me?
Well, I tell you, I certainly think there's mileage in it. I mean, I asked Sister Claire at the school for a girl from a tough area, and she sent me to a family of Holy Joes. I mean, I think they kept looking me up and down, you know, to see where I'd got the beads. Well, I agree with that, but you see, there was no way that they were representative. I mean, this was at the Divis Flats, Simon. Just wait till you see it. It's a slum. I mean, actually, you know, with the horror stories that come out of it, I'd be quite surprised if we find a normal kid there. Well, I'm going to have another go tomorrow afternoon.
What's that family like?
Well, I think they sound quite promising. The mother cleans at the school, but the father is unemployed, and the little girl is apparently very articulate.
Tina?
Yeah?
Did you go to the shop for me, love?
Yeah.
Get me 6 buns.
6 buns?
Yeah. And take 10p for yourself.
Okay.
Lift your legs. Frank.
Hi, what?
Lift your legs. You know that interviewer's coming soon?
Ma. When's that book with you?
Do you think I made him, Molly?
Hold on a minute, what's this for? More drink to be getting in the boller with, eh?
Fuck's sake.
What's that you say?
Oh, forget about it, Ma. Fuck this for a lark.
All about language in this house!
Fella's too big for his boots. Treats this place like a doss house.
What's him back again? He's had all the warnings he's getting.
How the hell is this?
Yes?
Here's your buns.
Oh, is there any change?
Yes.
What's that wee girl moan?
Look, Frank. You're being too hard on him. You know that? Jeannie Skillen told me that the Brits did give him a terrible beating. They done hurt Kevin as well.
Brits or no Brits? That fella's getting too big a mouth on him.
Oh, well, you know where he gets that from. Look, he's still a youngster. Do you want to knock the spirit out of him altogether?
No, I don't. I don't want him brought home the box one night either.
I won't argue with you now. That girl will be coming any minute to interview, will she?
What girl's this?
Do you never listen to a word I say? I told you Sister Claire got on to me at the school.
Is there any dough in it?
No, there's no dough in it.
It's just a wee interview. Look here. Take yourself out for a while, will ye?
Can't argue with that, love. There's a couple of bets here I fancy anyway.
I'll just make sure you're home in time for your supper.
Aye, all right. Oh, I've seen plenty of changes. I've seen a lot of bad things happen. But you know, there's good people living in Divis as well. A lot of good people. People that's lived in the parish all their lives and would never dream of moving away from St. Peter's.
Actually, I've been amazed. I think there's a tremendous sense of community here.
Oh, aye. Oh, it's true. You know, I would go as far as to say there's saints living in Divis Flats. Aye, saints. Oh, my goodness. What have we here? Some sense.
Hi, Kitty. You there? Oh, Mary. Run into Mr. Wonderful out there. Jesus, he's a grin on from ear to ear. What'd you do for him?
He's only after conning me out of £2. But for God's sake, Mary, anything at all to get rid of him for a couple of hours.
I'm going to borrow for a couple of messages. He coming up?
Oh, I can't. So that girl's coming from the BBC. Sister Claire sent her over to me.
Is that old boot still sticking her nose into your business?
No, you're not ways. Like, she will not take no for an answer.
You're not ways, Kitty.
And, like, these two are coming now any minute for Father Doherty's bringing her over here.
Won't you hear him away before he comes? Look, I'll see you later. I want to call down to Kitty Kelly's Blasius Down.
Again?
Aye, again. Shows me £2. Well, I want to get it off her in case she decides to go for good this time. So I'll see you later.
Okay. Hold on and I'll let you know what happened.
I'll take Grace in later on. Cheerio, oh, Kitty.
Okay, cheerio, Mary.
How are you, Mrs. Nolan?
Cheerio.
Are you home, Mrs. McAteer?
Oh, indeed I am, Father.
Oh, it's nice and warm in here anyway.
Ach, there you are, Catherine. Look, I'm only in for a minute or two. This is Sue McKenna, the young lady from the television that I was telling you about. Miss McKenna, Mrs. McAteer. This is Roisin's mother.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Oh, I've known the family a long time.
Oh,
a long
father.
Time. Aye, well, there you are then. I better be off now, Kathleen.
Are you sure you don't want a cup of tea, Father?
Oh, no, thanks. No. I have other calls to make, you know.
Oh, well, I'll see you at the door there.
That's fine. Well, bye-bye, Miss McKenna. I'll probably see you next week.
Oh, yes, bye-bye, Father. Thank you.
Don't be putting any more scripts on. I'll end up like the last one. I just threw them out.
Hell, it wasn't made, under.
Shit, that's your deck on. Oh, shit. Whoa.
Did you freak all right?
Bucked any runners on there?
Oh, no.
Thanks, Noel.
Oh, well, let me try and explain it to you then. Well, it's to be a documentary programme about children growing up in Northern Ireland. I mean, it's actually part of a series, you know, from all over Britain. And really what we want is for the children to tell us themselves about living through the Troubles.
Well, does this mean you're after more scandal about the flats?
Sorry?
Well, from what I've seen, that's all you people seem to come here for.
All right, Mrs. McAteer, so you're right about a lot of us people.
I suppose you're different.
But let's face it, this place is a scandal. I mean, you know, you've got soldiers creeping around with guns out there. You have got joyriders that must make the place an absolute death trap for kids. I mean, there are no jobs. There are the most piffling amenities. I mean, you know, what sort of effect do you think this is having on the children? Would you rather no one said anything about that?
But sure, this has already been publicised. As a matter of fact, that seems to be the only kind of publicity we get.
Well, that's just the point, because we want our film to show that places like this have a heart as well. I mean, just like anywhere else.
Oh, this place has got a heart, all right. But you have to live here to find it.
And do you see much of the place around the flats?
See two cops, you'll see a whole crowd of Brits.
Roisin, tell me about the soldiers. What sort of things do they do?
Well, Saturday night we weren't saying nothing, and they came along and started cursing at us. You know, calling us names and all. So we all started singing, "Don't cry for me, Argentina." And see, Martin Nolan was with us. Martin Nolan has a sweet dog called Starsky. See, Martin Nolan used to have a sweet dog called Starsky. You see, and they threw it over the balcony and killed it.
Just because it barked at them all the time.
And the Brits came walking up the corridor backwards. And she yells out, "If God wanted you to walk like that, he'd give you eyes in your backside."
She didn't say backside.
No, she's the worst word in it. She hates them, so she does.
And do you think it's right to hate them?
I think it's right. I think it's natural, you know, you would hit someone who killed your wee dog.
Same as you'd like someone who blew up a school. And who'd want to blow up school?
We would, so we'd all go home.
Nearly happened, though, hasn't it?
We nearly got sent back last time, but to find out it was a hoax, Johnny McAvoy did it.
And he told everybody as well, we fool.
Wonderful stories like the Hound of the Baskervilles. Every night that hound howled. Every night that horrible howling. Found out what the howling was. It was tangled up in a toilet roll. I prefer the good old British bobber. You can't beat him. Especially when he's got a report to the inspector about a murder and he says, "Well, now, sir, I've got on the victim later. During the war..."
Right when I meet you.
Jesus Christ, smell him. Something crawled by his arse and died.
We get up, your dinner's out.
Next he was a traffic warden.
Your dinner's out.
Come on, right. All night, will you get up?
Then he joined the team as a union leader.
Your dinner.
Was he the sort of man who had enemies?
Nothing better than your say.
I'm trying to watch this. You're making him quiet.
Got to come and leave right now. He's
away you and get my dinner, will you?
I'm trying to watch the TV.
Dusty bin, here he is.
Teresa, away and get my dinner for me, will you? Come on. Go on, away and get your dad's dinner.
And what a splendid copper he made. Great copper.
The
top and
the
copper
bottom.
You're a
wee
angel.
For God's sake, we're going to have to clean them. Mad, you got my jacket from the cleaners?
It's behind your room door where you can see it.
Huh?
Maddie, how are you?
Very well, thanks.
Looking lovely, is that it? I know that you also keep that same thing with you.
Right, come on, son. Get up and let your head mother sit down. A little different for you, isn't it? Oh, come on, I've been on my feet all day.
Kiddie series really fought for large children, but adults as well. About invention.
You're torn for the dishes, isn't it, Roisin?
Sure, film stars don't wash dishes.
Neither do they live in this house.
That's where we are.
Roisin.
But you love it, Dad. Your mommy keeps you nice.
Aye. He went after a bet.
Are you going to eat it?
Thanks for the jacket, man.
Bill and Julie Jenkinson. Hey, from you and Pauline going up to the Lake Glen?
Aye, me and Pauline's going out, all right.
Well, with that jacket on, men, they don't give you a job as a waiter.
Aye, 12 seasons Halloween, the boogies day. When you get back with the OU, we're going to all have a laugh.
Away, oh, and I broke more boogies hearts than you've had hot dinners.
Really? Just stone cold. Heartbreaker.
See?
See us.
In Borneo until you were 10. I'm sorry. You're not going out then, Tony?
No, I'm not going out.
Now, Bill, you're what's popularly known
as PR. What's that? No, I'm not going out. I've no money, sure.
Really?
What
sort of things are you investigating? Well, Jason, you've all statements for defence and a little bit divorced. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, divorce is very popular these days, isn't it?
Sort of
especially challenge. Among married people.
That's right.
Yeah. And you got a little baby you just had a little while ago, yes? Yeah. Then we shall...
Remember I told you, but...
That's it. Hello, David.
Dead on. Well, I'll see you later.
Two ways you can stop you if you make a mistake or run out of time. If you don't know an answer, Bill, or whatever, you don't know, stop, pass, whatever. And build up your score. This question here is
does
about...
Does everybody have to have a row with you to get a bonus in this house?
We will give you the slang and we want you to say what it stands for. Now, digs is a word for logic. So that's the one we'll start you with. Digs is a word for... dough.
Yeah. Take out for yourself.
Jasper.
Christmas is early.
The Brine. Rosie Lee.
This way. Through here.
Is this the entrance through this shack?
No shack, darling. This is the bloody hotel.
Right.
How you been?
All right.
Good.
All right. Come on, Jill.
Yeah, no problem. Told you.
It's the first time anything like that's ever happened to me.
Yeah, the last time I was here, this director was such a bloody idiot. He got us awfully beat.
Why? What did he do?
Oh,
Jesus, here's where I had the ball charming again. Hope he doesn't start singing.
See, if he starts singing his LP, the night we'll be here on night, you know, somewhere. What is that one he sings? You know that one.
What, the crystal chandelier?
Aye, what is it he says? The marble statuette.
Instead of the marble statuette.
And all around.
What about your woman? What about your woman? What he's like?
Rosa.
What's the matter with you, Kelly? You're right depressed. Look at me.
I hope she doesn't start.
I caught my little petrol ball. Oh, Jesus, no.
What? Tell me, I caught Tony with a petrol bomb in his pocket.
When was that?
Last night.
Where had he gone?
In the house.
You're joking.
Does he stand?
Oh, he doesn't, and that's what I'm worried about. Jesus, now, you know what he was like that time. He wouldn't even believe that he got beat up by the Brits. So how am I going to tell him?
If I'm sure I'd be careful. Where are you saying that?
Of course, you never know who you're talking to. You see where all these supergrasses are not going to be?
I mean, it doesn't take you far to be caught doing anything now. Like, you know you're
right,
yourself, Vera. You know,
the ambassadors have an awful lot to answer for.
Aye, but how can anybody live him? How can a woman live for a man like that? I mean, how could you respect yourself? I mean, you'd have no respect for yourself, would you?
You're dead right. You couldn't,
you couldn't,
did
it?
Mary, I mean,
they're only a little bit bastard. Like, let's face it.
If it was me, imagine I'd go with him. Like, I'm not talking about the money, but if it was me,
I'd get away off, for God's sake. You mean to say, like, that you could do that? You could just get up and go and leave? You're knowing that he's standing up in court and he's sinking 30 people and he's breaking up 30 families?
What about that girl? All right, her man retracted his statements. She's still going about saying she's the super tight's wife. Like, I mean, it's all following her.
No, but he didn't think of his wife and kids when he was doing it. And you could do that? You mean you can actually do that?
He's only thinking of himself and his money.
What about me and the kids? Like, it's left behind.
Well, look, will he tell you? I know. Everybody has a different way of looking at it. I know what you're trying to say, and I can understand it. I know that you can get upset and you can understand about these things.
I know. I mean, everybody has a different way. Well, she would have been the last person in the world I would ever.
I know, but I mean, everybody has their own opinion.
Well, look, I think that everybody has to face it when it comes to their own door, and there's nothing that anybody can say in any of our doors. But I'll tell you one thing. Do you see, if I thought I could get a fiver, I would let them have my own lot anytime.
Oh, here she is.
Hello, how are you?
Sue, take a seat.
Still in one piece?
So far, touch wood. Why, has there been any trouble?
Look, I've told you there's nothing to worry about. There are more murders in New York in one day than you get here in, what, 20 minutes?
Right, at least for hotels in New York, they don't look like a concentration camp. You've been here 3 weeks. How can you stand it?
Well, you'd miss all the bombings anyway.
Oh, don't talk like that. It only helps to make those things happen. I really believe that. What would you like to drink?
I'm not in Blackpool, this is still in Kenya, right?
Oh.
The best thing we know, the cameraman disappears. The hippo disappeared before.
You're all right, Angel. Have a nice last pint. See you later.
Yeah, see you.
There's about six usable voices in each.
I'm Andrew Hatch, the camera person.
Hello, I'm Sue McKenna, I'm the researcher.
Well, you must have been here for a while. Where have you been hiding?
Well, I've hardly been hiding. I've been out all over the place.
Come on. Oh, come on. Look what he's written. Band on the Run. Silly love songs yesterday.
Yeah, but they're not all brilliant, are they?
Oh, come on. Every now and then a man writes a classic.
Well, name one, huh?
All right, what about Moloch and Tyler?
Oh, God.
All right, what about Ebony and Ivy, then?
Yeah, well, that's a bit more my lane. Stevie Wonder. Yeah?
All right, so this is the new lodge. What about the family there?
Well, that one's still on the edge. I mean, I think the boy would do it, you know, but it's the parents in that case.
And what about the girl you saw this afternoon?
Now, she is terrific, that girl. I mean, she's on one of these tapes.
Think we'll ever get anything to eat? I'm starving.
Andrew.
Oh, Sam.
Hiya.
Good to see you.
I just thought I'd give you an idea of what I'm up to.
Yeah?
It's great to have a local cameraman. It makes the job much easier for me.
Well, it makes a difference in all the news footage we've been covering. Someone who knows what he wants. Hey, Ricky?
Yeah. Well, Sue's done some good work. She's got some great kids from both sides of the community.
It takes you 2 hours getting them things up, so it does.
It takes me 2 hours getting them down, and it takes him 2 hours getting it up.
Are you still thinking about sex?
Well, sure, when you're not getting enough of it, what else can you talk about?
Oh, well, you know what I mean.
I told you what Lily was like when she gets a few at her.
And they gave me the tender smile.
Did you not tell him about the claim?
No.
Tell him how he got. Would he hear this? Not so weird. It'll make you laugh.
I was in bed.
Well, David was saying.
And I hear just nothing. The window. And the wee voice saying, let us have love. Come on, let us have love. And I knew straight away here it was.
Yeah.
I think it does the run. So anyway, I sneaks into the bathroom and I brings out a basin of cold water, opens the window, and there he's hanging there like frozen. I said, I let you in, all right. So I throws the basin of water right up to
so she's up the
No, I am not deep. Anyway, I bangs the window. Just love the thing, like, so I was really worried about it. So I went into bed and went to sleep. Anyway, to cut a long story short, I hears a lot of months later, he's round in the club and drinks all round.
Jack a lad.
Oh. No, he wouldn't spend Christmas on our bed. So I goes round and sits down the table, spies me, and he comes over and he says, what do you have in love?
You said about it.
I did.
You did?
By the neck.
Thought it was Christmas.
I says to him, have a claim you got. Oh, well, geez, you've seen the colour. It went like he went white as a sheet. And he says to me, claim. I says, look, don't give me that, Jane. I says, I heard all about it. You got a claim because you said you tripped on a broken pavement stone and broke your leg. But I know you didn't. And if you don't give me that money, I'm going down to the cops and I'll get you 6 months, you'll end up for a deep thing. You want to see me hopping out of that club? I'd be like a fairy.
Don't you look well, Maisie?
I wish, shouldn't I look well? Since it's about time I got something off and just stick a little long enough to do it.
Double paranoia.
Oh, No, I mean, it was only a couple of pounds, like, wasn't thousand, so it wasn't.
Do you want me to go and break his other leg?
I tell you what, the 4 legs would be great. It used to be like money in a bank, so I wouldn't.
Okay, Sue and I are going to go on ahead. Can you give that a push?
Yes, sure.
Well, see you out there, Jill. All right.
Okay, right. See you.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, boys, not too much of a hangover.
Hey, Jill.
Now, there's a football match at Spring Martin this morning and some establishing shots of Divis Flats this afternoon.
Both sides at once, eh?
If you're lucky.
You got the keys to the car?
Yeah, there you go. You going to load the max?
Yeah.
Okay.
Miss Devlin, please go to their telephone.
What system
we
got?
It's all Bang & Olufsen, isn't it? It's not cheap gear either, I tell you.
That's
that.
Right, same sort of gear I've got.
Yeah?
Hey, if you ever get a job in England, look me up, I can get it a bit cheaper.
Yeah, we've got a job to do here, so hurry up. Okay. Now, look, is it OK if I squeeze in between you two?
I've heard about you, Jill.
It's all true. Look, come on, hurry up, we've got a job to do.
Come on, then.
Right, Jordan.
Jordan.
What is that? Packers! All right, Tony, what about you? Here, come in. Can't see anything.
What? Nothing. Tragic. Look.
Sleeping, isn't it?
It's only a fiver.
Nah, you're right, Mackers. You're too small for me anyway.
Sure, no, Iris, then what's it, Pat?
I'm sure you'll find somebody to get it.
Go on, man. Here, what's this here about your kid? What about Rolly's cameraman?
I can make it somehow fun about it or something, No, I don't know why it is.
Sure?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
She has some gear, hasn't she? Worth some money.
Uh-huh, she's worth a few bucks.
Here. My chance of doing a wee job. No. Get this gear, like.
Nah, she didn't know what them's are like. Nah, be no way, Maggers.
Okay, I'll see you later.
What are you doing up there? Come here down and watch you, skinny. If a man sees you doing that there, she'll kill you, so she will.
What did you want anyway?
When's them's come to make out their film about you?
Wednesday.
Oh, that'll be brilliant.
And they're bringing all their stuff, all their cameras and all, eh?
No, they're going to bring us the Mickey Mouse one. You want to squirt all the water out?
I do some cheeky, all right?
Yeah, please.
Here's my man.
Hi, Sheila.
You all right, Tony?
Well.
Go on up and keep away and him, love, will you?
Ach, Mummy, the way he's up, I'm only sitting here.
I'm only going over to see Vera about getting my hair done.
He'll be all right, I got my
mouth. Can I not forget about the grey one, Sheila?
Watch it, Joey.
Anyway, why do you want to know?
I just want to know.
Aye, but why do you want to know? Look, Tony, I want to be on TV. I don't want you spoiling everything. And if anything goes missing, I know who did it.
Ach, dry your eyes, will you, wee girl? Don't want to
look,
do nothing.
Anyway, I don't want you getting into trouble.
Ach, stop your gurning, will you?
Well, it's as good as it's gonna be.
Come on, Andy, that one's crucial.
Freaking kids keep looking down the camera. What do you expect?
Get out of the way.
Keep your eye on it, mate, will you? Your eyes and your arse are in this place.
All right, I'll go with it.
Gate clear.
What do you reckon next, Sue?
Well, I think the swings don't do well with the kids.
Okay. Everybody down the swings.
Come on, gang.
Okay.
Are you gonna be warm enough?
All right, we're gonna do the swings now. Come on, Regine, show us the way.
Okay, Regine, we'll get you on one of these swings in a minute.
Can I be in the car with you?
Please!
No, your face is too dirty.
If you like it, if you like it. Come on. Quack, a low one. If you do a quick turn.
Look, can you hang on for a second? Can you
what
hang on?
I think you're doing my stunts.
Look, can we borrow your swing just for 5 minutes, please?
I'm shit. I'm playing this all day.
Look, will you just go for 5 minutes, please?
5 minutes? No chance. Mummy.
No, I'll give you £1, right?
Pound?
There you are.
There you are. Look.
No, just him. Just shut up. Be quiet, the rest of you. Whole pound, please. Just 5 minutes, all right?
Not a pound,
that's all I've got now. Will you get that and get away? 5 minutes, please. Just 5 minutes.
5 minutes? Off you. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
Go on, off you go. Come on, we're not ITV, you know. Right, now, are you okay? Right, you just stay there. Can we get it in a little bit closer, please? Sorry, boy. You've
got 5 minutes before these clouds come over.
It's a bloody place to put yours, aren't you?
Well, Jeff, you can have a look at the yours tonight as well. And, if we set a few things up, we'll
okay, sir. Hey, Andy. Hey, can you get a shot of that?
Come on, Ricky. Get the tape. I'll
do it handheld.
Christ!
Get right in there, get close in.
Get pretty quiet when you see this. Okay.
That's about all you get. You want any more?
No, okay, cut there.
Okay. End board.
34 take one.
Great. Great, Sue. This is fantastic. Well done.
Great. But it would have been so fantastic if it had been his pulse that had gone up in there.
I get sick, don't I?
Lots of vegetables.
Yeah, I'll have runner beans.
Runner beans.
Yeah, and cauliflower.
And how would you like your steak done?
Medium, please.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Shouldn't we wait a little bit longer for Andrew?
No. Well, he did promise his wife a night in.
We've been away quite a bit lately, so it's my guess the poor lad's stuck.
Doesn't he miss his kids?
Well, he's sentimental about the little buggers because he hardly sees them. I love the game soup, porterhouse steak rare, green beans and mushroom sticks.
Andy!
Hi.
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 Managed to get away.
Oh, good.
Hey, Georgie, how's it going?
Good evening, sir.
You on order?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'll have the patty maison, beef bourguignon and just green toss salad.
Very good.
Okay. Were you all ordered a drink?
I was wondering if everyone would be happy with Cote de Rhone.
Oh, that's lovely.
Two bottles, thanks.
Thank you. £15 anyway. £2 and £5 and £3. Uh-huh. Oh, in the bottom of the garden. Uh-huh. She wants a what? Seesaw? I'll see when I get back. Okay?
But I think you're like the little boys. He's very talkative, isn't she? Did you get through okay, Phil?
Yeah, she told me I've got 6 weeks in the Cameroons after this one.
It's worse for some people.
I don't even know where they are. Off Scotland, innit?
Lovely. Andy and I were in this job for UTV last week up the Falls Road.
Oh, yeah, the one with the kid?
Yeah. We're driving along, right? Suddenly, this car nearly puts us off a road. I thought, Christ, gunman, probably. And there's this six-year-old kid standing up in the front seat, all over the place, right, left, and bloody center, laughing his head off. 6-year-old. Had to pick him out of the fencing at the dole office.
Was he hurt?
Was he hurt? Little bastard was lucky he didn't kill anybody.
Yeah, but why do you think a 6-year-old behaves like that in the first place?
Because there's too many of them, that's why. And there's no control over them. Parents give them a slice of bread, throw them out in the street, and then they go off down the boozer. And they're poor as rags of a few more kids. Chuck some bombs and then say the Protestants are keeping them down.
Which they are, aren't they, to be fair?
Well, you can hardly talk about fair, can you?
I beg your pardon?
Well, it's a bit of a biased opinion from somebody who's supposed to be having an unbiased view of the situation.
You're talking about I'm an individual, I'm as entitled to my opinion as the next person.
Not if you don't know the facts, you're not.
Well, you're telling me I don't know the facts. Actually, it is my job to know the facts.
Hey, come on, you guys. No shopping, no politics over the dinner table. Right?
Sorry. Must be too much rum in this cake.
Anyway, it'll be obvious whose interpretation it is. I wrote the commentary 3 weeks ago.
Okay, okay. Yeah, I know what you're getting at.
But, say, some of these Provo stories that you read in the papers, the English news swallows at home. I mean, it's just laughable.
Yes, but from whose point of view?
Yeah, from anybody's point of view, if you ask me.
Well, I better go. I promised I'd meet Richie's family at a social tonight.
Sue, don't go just yet.
No, no, Willie. I said I'd be there by 9.
Working overtime, eh?
If anything does come out of it, I'll let you know. Enjoy your coffee.
There's more to keep a change.
And not just behave yourself. You know what he's like whenever he gets started.
That's just the drink, man.
The glad all more respectable, you know what I mean?
The girls go out.
Get it.
They're coming from England. They're filming our movie. It
might be a bit like that.
It feels so right, so wrong with you. I need to know what you feel too. Baby, I'm wrong. Won't you tell me?
Here's that for a common night.
Hello? Sorry, I'm a bit late.
Well, see, you managed to find your way here, anyway.
Yes, I did. I'm getting quite familiar with it all now.
Well, you don't want to get too familiar with it, eh?
Oh, I must introduce you. This is my husband, Frank.
Pleased to meet you.
Hello. This is Tony. Tony! Tony! This is my son, Tony.
Sorry, love, would you like a drink?
Oh, yes, I'll have an orange juice, thank you.
A vodka and orange?
No, 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 just an orange.
A pure orange juice. Tony. Tony.
Go way up to the bar and get the lady a pure orange juice, eh?
I'll be back.
Here's my man.
And this is Pauline.
Hello.
And this is my other son, Jerry. then Pauline's going to be mad enough to marry.
Now wait up, will you?
This is Sue McKellar, the girl from the BBC.
What,
Gary,
the tea,
you do?
There you are. Tony, are you not going to ask Sue to dance?
Stop, Ma.
Yeah.
One which would you for lunch anyway? One which he'd have to pay for. And one which we'd swallow for nothing. Right, Ricky?
Yeah.
Well, boss, what does that mean? He wouldn't even pay the extra hour. We had to shoot the whole thing when the sun was right high in the sky. I mean, it just looked like frig all.
Are you boys ready for another drink?
No, not for me,
thanks. Sure.
Yeah.
No, it's for you and Sergio, mm-hmm. Please.
I'll have a wee boost, John.
I'll give you a hand.
Look, darling, take it from the joint account. That's what the joint account's for.
Simon, another drink?
No, thanks.
Sure.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. No, it's Jill. Yeah.
Are you coming or are you waiting around for something? No. Reckon I'll hang on for a bit. Yeah, I thought you might. Just be sure you make the call in the morning, all right? Okay.
See you, lads.
See you, Ricky.
Bye-bye.
You sleep well, Ricky?
Yeah.
Good night. I'll see you in the morning, lads.
See you, Simon.
See you, Simple.
Says that he needs to get his wife organized.
Well, I can't, but, mate, we got a saying. Keeping Will fat and poorly shod. It keeps him under the hammer. Here, got a story. Yeah, when I was in Malta, this carpenter told me a story. It's a pub, you see.
Yeah.
In this pub, standing by the bar, it's this big Irish thick mick, isn't there?
Hey, watch it, will you?
Where'd you come from?
Belfast.
This guy come from Dublin, you see. So he's standing there, he's having a drink. So through the door comes this big bleating silvery moon. And this silvery moon's got a big basket under his arm. Puts it down, so this bleating paddy says, like, bleeding dirty black sods coming over here, nicking all our jobs.
And when we can't get nothing to a bleeding or liver or nothing. So he said,
come to the pub's lawyer.
He said, need more of that, he said, and you're out.
He said, well, bleeding silvery moons coming here, nicking all our women, God knows what else.
He said, like, any more, that's a liberal pub. He said, you're out. He said, anybody drinks in here. He said, that. Thanks, darling. He said, put it down on 43. Did she tell you?
BBC?
That's right, yes.
Well, have you been here before?
No, I haven't. This is my first time in Belfast.
Oh. Well, then they'll have shown you the sights. Ian Pearsley, like...
Oh, come on, you know, it's not just the disasters we're after.
Oh, well, then you won't be going up to Stormont, will you? Have you been heading?
So say for a drink.
Do you think I could possibly buy one of these, up
you? No, I should think I would.
Are you sure?
Yeah, go ahead.
You finish with it?
Right, go ahead, kid.
Captain McAteer, please still sir. Captain McAteer. Give a big round of applause. Thank you very much, kids.
I see us flashing our lights at you back there.
I'm sorry, I must have been miles away.
Have a look at your driver's license, please.
Look, I'm sorry, but I think I've left all my cards in another jacket.
Right, we'll have you out of the car, please. Please.
Thank you.
Right, what's your name and address?
Sue McKenna. I'm staying at the Europa.
The Europa? Where have you been tonight?
I was at a social club just around the corner from here.
Is that where you got this?
Social club? That's a Provo drinking den, love.
No, I think you're wrong about that, you know. It's just, a dancing place.
Do you support the Provos?
Look, I am a researcher and I'm making a television documentary. I've left my cards back at the hotel. If you both come back with me, you're quite welcome to see them.
Another crowd is over here making a film about the poor, underprivileged nationalist minority.
You should go to the border and interview the widows and children of unarmed policemen and UDR men murdered by the same brave Provies.
Go and run a check, will you, Tommy? Just gonna run a check on you, miss.
Yes, Tommy.
Okay.
Right, miss. You're free to go. Here's your paper back. Sorry about him. He tends to get a wee bit upset, you know. Night, Nate.
Working overtime.
Been having enough of that bothering my chest this last winter, Mick.
A few help bronchitis, haven't you, Mary?
Aye, sometimes, yeah. You know, when I go home here at night, I can hardly breathe. Do you know, only I need my cup of shunts. I would give this a whole lot in the morning, so
would
what?
I.
Sometimes I'd love to lie in bed and say, oh, I couldn't be annoyed, can I? Because you get that all tired.
What's wrong with you, Mary? What do you need to lay a lad to rub your chest, lady? You have nothing to complain about.
Do you not think I had enough of my lads a week in the Bahamas? I want not a bloody old lad.
You have queerly changed your tune. There was a time you'd have given anything for an old lad to rub your chest.
I know, but here last night I wasn't a kick of the arse off the Bahamas. One number done me out of the 500. And do you know who won it? Done old Lady McInerney. Jesus Christ, I was raging.
That old dog with all the money.
That's right, she got it, so she did. Just think what I could have done with that money.
Good God, it just shows you.
These days in the Bahamas and I'd have been flying. Drink. Food, men, flan and all that.
Sure, that mud wouldn't give you the steam of her piss.
I know, and I was sitting there sweating. I was raging. £500 in Bahamas.
Oh, Mary. Knowing you, it would last you 2 days.
Don't let me distract you from your work, Mrs. Nolan. Could I have a word with you, Kathleen? I gather the young lady from London was delivered to you safely by Father Doherty.
Yes, sister, they were already round and made a few films for Roisin going through the flats.
Well, I'm sure she'll be a credit to the school knowing you, Kathleen.
Thank you, sister.
I don't think there's anybody else they require now.
Your sister, my Michelle, could do it.
Indeed, Mrs. Nolan. If we ever saw Michelle, I'm sure she could. Good afternoon to you, Kathleen. Mrs. Nolan.
So exciting about it all. The old guy had to walk past the shop 8 times.
8 times?
Oh, I know, I'm awful serious about it. I nearly forgot how to walk past it, so that.
Yeah. I will. I used to want to pick me, so what? I'd love to do it.
Here, guess who I'm really got some fancies.
Who?
Johnny. He's the biggest geek I've ever seen. He really thinks he's lovely too.
Well, it was candy all night. I had a bunk in the disco. I couldn't get any more.
There she goes again, gardening as usual.
I know.
You're always complaining about Mama.
Hey, what's this here film really like? Is it good?
It is. It's all right. It's about, you know, how I live and all. And they say, oh, like, Divis has got a bad thing, hasn't it, name? And I say, no. It's just like people at school say that.
Josie
Mac is
here.
Oh, no, there's Tracy Regan and her miss. Come on. Right, come on.
Roisin, get your order, bro.
See what's right now.
Hello, Kathleen, we're here. Are you ready for the onslaught?
Indeed.
Is it short if we go on through?
Yes,
they'll be bringing lots of
equipment. Okay, lads.
Oh, I beg your pardon, sorry.
Roisin,
Now, it'll take us a little while to set up, so if you just want to sit down there and relax for a bit. All right? Andy, we'll stay with what we first thought of and have her in the armchair against that wall, OK? Yeah, OK.
I had to put the camera in the corner, OK, so I better get rid of the telly.
Hey, listen, I wouldn't leave any other gear around about then. I could take a walk.
Yeah, well, I'm going down there now.
I do.
Hello. Hi, son, is everything OK?
Yeah, fine.
You know we have to be out of here by 4 o'clock.
Right, better get our skates on.
Come on, Joe, come on, I got work here, you know that.
There's the first pub.
What's up, Phil?
I have to get out of this. I'll have to check the fuse box.
Oh, shit. OK, well, look, let's have the blonde here, all right? And, we'll have the redhead as a backlight in there and another redhead over there. And put a trace and a blue on each of them, will you?
All right, you want a bus?
OK, good man. All right, Mike, we'll put in the tall legs over there. Many bags you got, Phil? Good. Here, take that for me, will you?
Roisin, would you like to come over here? Now, listen, I'd like you just to sit down here and Simon's going to come and ask some questions and then they'll put a microphone on you, OK?
Okay, look, I'm just going to clip this on here so that I can hear what you're saying. I'll try not to touch it with your hands, okay?
Here, Mike, you'll be able to do a commercial for Rumbelows after this job.
See you in the camera room, sir.
It's not just our Roisin you should be talking to, you know. Our Tony got a beating from the army just the other week. He's still got a bruise that size in his back.
Yeah, well, I heard they can be pretty nasty, those guys.
I could get him up to show it to you.
Well, look, he's the man you ought to see about that there. I just record a sound, you know. Roisin, could you say something for me there, please, though, just so I can get a level?
Something.
Come on, you
lot. I was just saying, you should talk to our Tony as well. And he got beaten up by a soldier just on his way home.
God, that's awful, Mr. McAteer. Is he all right?
Well, he's walking all right, but he's still got a bruise.
They need to bend up another 3 inches, probably.
Yeah, well, I don't know. There's a bloody wire here. Hang on a minute. We taking this down?
Yeah.
I bet he wishes we was about on Good Friday, don't you?
Come on, lads, get a move on, will you?
Yeah, the problem is we don't have any room for him.
But I mean, there's plenty of stories you could tell around here.
Hello, Frank. Look, I'm terribly sorry to take Simon away from you like this. I've got a few questions I want to ask him about Roisin. It's about the transfer. I've got 4 or 5 questions down
there. Frank, 20 minutes. I'm way
upstairs. Hey, girls, there's no need to run about like a pack of elephants.
OK, Simon, ready to knock this off.
Yeah. Ready, Ricky?
Sound ready.
All right, then, let's go.
TDNR.
It's extremely crowded in here. Can we get rid of a couple of these,
come on,
please?
Girls. Come on, out of the way. Come on. I know I said you could say, but it's too crowded.
But it's just
no, come on, please, out.
Can I put someone else?
No, no, out. Come on. Go on. Thank
right,
you.
Right, girls, Roisin will see you later.
Right, can we go now, please?
Hold it. There's a banging noise somewhere.
That'll be those wee lads at the rubbish chute again.
OK, Phil. Save our legs.
Jill, can you sort that out for me, please? All right, relax, everybody.
Sit around with the radio, you know, we talk a lot, like, play games, say and watch TV, you know.
But that's not all children find to do around here, is it, Roisin? There are other kinds of excitement, more dangerous kinds.
You mean, like, lighting fires and joyriding? Sometimes the wee lads steal cars and go joyriding. Sometimes the wee girls do as well. That kind of thing.
Well, tell me a bit more about it. Children much younger than you get up to it, don't they? What do you think of that?
Not all of them do. Like, I know some kids go wild, but I know some people that don't even like to go out. Whatever you do, it doesn't mean to say you'd rather do it, you know?
I know, like, an empty flat may make a good game for a while, but I'd love to have a garden, you know, to play in. I'd look after it, so what?
Okay, Regine. Now, you must have seen a lot of things that trouble you around here. How do you think that's affected you?
Cut.
Well, better see who this is.
Good girl, I was smashing.
Kathleen, come on, quick! We've finished shooting!
Jesus Christ, I don't know who it is.
Will you get that camera? Did you see just her? Name of Christ.
It's Kathleen.
I know, love, I know. No, shush, the ambulance will be here soon.
What happened? Can you tell me exactly what happened?
There's nothing you can do.
Keep her low, can't you see? She's hurt. Bloody vultures.
Is she dead?
Do you know what that is? That's a plastic bullet. That's what your bloody fame, British soldiers, shoot at our kids to kill them. Don't turn your face away. Look at her. Look at the damage that it does. Now, will you show that on your British television and let the people know what the British soldiers are doing to our children? Will you let them know what they're doing? They're murdering them.
Go away.
Hello, Simon. How are things? Yeah, I'm looking at them right now, as it happens. Well, they're not too bad. A bit soft and shaky in places, but I've seen worse. I think they'll be all right. I'll tell you what, Simon. I'll send them over to Alan's cutting room and you can have a word with him, OK?
Bye-bye. Well, the rushes weren't that great.
Oh, no. Can't you use any of them?
They don't do what I thought they'd do.
What do you mean?
I mean what I say. They won't stand up on their own.
So that's the end of it, then, is it, then?
No. I've arranged a meeting with the army for tomorrow to find out what happened.
But we know what happened.
Yeah. But we have to find out the other side, don't we?
Thank you.
over there, sir. We're in the reception, thank you. Get a cup of tea, soldier. Come on, Prince. How you doing, boys? All right?
Yeah, all right, sir. Sorry.
How'd you get on?
Thank you.
Okay. Alright.
You done fuck all, scratching your bollocks all night.
He's in here, look at him.
Don't have a choice to matter you.
Go on, you lazy bastards, get out there and do some work.
Next to the bar.
Come on in, boys. Now, boys, you need your brother.
Mr. Ward, Miss McKenna, Major Green, how do you do?
How do you do?
Glad to come this way. Now, your boss is married Taylor Smith, I hear.
Yes.
Yeah, not that I know him, but I was at school with his brother Eddie.
Oh, are you indeed?
Well, you seem to be weathering the storm.
Yes, well, we do our best. This place used to be a hotel, can you imagine? Must have been quite extraordinary in its heyday. Thank you, Gibson.
Thank you.
I happened to see your last documentary, Mr. Ward, and if I may say so, I found it a very striking piece of work.
Thank you.
Miss McKenna, I don't know yet, but I'm sure I will. I know, too, that you've got a very good local crew working with you. There's a wealth of talent here. If only you got half a chance to develop. A marvellous raconteurs. Tragedy, really, that so much of it goes to waste.
Yes, we saw an example of that tragedy the other day.
Ah, yes, the girl who was hit. Were you there when it happened?
No, but we arrived very soon afterwards.
Did you get any film?
Yes. We took some film, but we didn't stay long. The local people were very upset.
Mm. We have a job to do here ourselves, of course. We're used to seeing some terrible things in the course of it. Not long before your incident, five of our men got blown off the map in an ambush. It's not easy, even when one's hardened to it.
I wanted to talk about what happened at Divis in the context of how the army deals with children on the streets.
Yes. Well, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid that's out at the moment. The Royal Ulster Constabulary takes responsibility for policing the streets, so I'll have to refer you to them on the general question. That's policy. As far as the girl is concerned, our press office has issued a number of statements.
Yes, I've read them. One might be forgiven for thinking them less than consistent with the facts.
Really?
Yes, for instance, they tend to build up a picture of a riot. But there was no riot at the time of the incident, as far as we could see.
Yes, well, with respect, you've just said that you weren't there to see the incident itself. These things flare up and die down again very quickly, and one has to be very careful with what one hears from people in a community like that. There's nothing the IRA likes better than the death of a child, even if they have to do it themselves. This is a war of propaganda.
I understand that, Major Green. Perhaps we could have an account of this riot from a soldier who was on the actual patrol.
Absolutely impossible. I do realize that in your job you've got to keep an open mind, but that ought to work both ways, don't you think? Could be very unfortunate if it looked as if you were siding with the terrorists against the army.
You don't have to teach me how to make programs, Major Green. We're not dealing with terrorists, we're dealing with young children.
Yes, well, the RUC can put you straight about them. I'm sure they'd be very grateful to learn at what age a child is too young to be a terrorist.
The local people insist that the girl was shot from a British armored car.
Yes, well, we all know the local people. I've checked with the RUC, and they'll help you in any way they can. I know you want this program to be memorable, but, well, really, what are you saying? That our soldiers take pot shots at the public. I know my men, and they don't shoot innocent young girls.
He had a lot of style, didn't he?
He obviously had no intention of giving us anything, so that's that.
I just don't understand all this talk about a riot. We were there, there wasn't any riot. Fucking whitewash.
Sue, do you think you can get me another interview with Regine?
These, Roisin.
Right.
Look, check a window, Lily isn't the first child that's been killed here. And unfortunately, she won't be the last.
Look, Mrs. McAteer, naturally you're concerned about Roisin. I understand how you...
Oh, do you? Do you really?
Then would you explain to me why you people haven't said one word about this killing?
Yes, well, I can only speak for myself. And I promise you, look, I wouldn't ask you to do this, would I? Unless I thought it could do at least, you know, a little bit of good. I mean, don't you see that there's just got to be some way of getting across to the people of England what's going on here?
Look, when Sister Claire asked me to let Roisin do this, well, I agreed. Well, mostly because Roisin was all for it, although she wouldn't admit it. But, I mean, this killing has put an entirely different light on things.
Mrs. McAtee, if you don't take the chances there are, quite frankly, what else are you going to get? Now, look, you will be there yourself. Look, you can stop it at any time if it looks as if it's getting too upsetting for Roisin. Now, please, trust me, I promise you that.
Look, if Roisin wants to speak to you, well, I won't stop her. But if she doesn't, then that's the end of it.
Roisin? Roisin, just come here a minute. We'd like to come back to your house and finish talking to you, like before.
Yeah.
Now, I've spoken to your mother here, and she's...
Now, you speak for yourself, Roisin.
Will you want to be talking about Jacqueline to me?
Well, I think that might be a part of it. Would you do that?
If you really want to talk about Jacqueline, you should talk to our Teresa. She was outside at the time.
But Teresa was outside when Jacqueline...
Yes.
Was...
I'll talk to you if she talks to you.
Okay.
Well, I think we might manage that.
What's that?
If you ask me, Simon's a bit of a chancer. I mean, he doesn't realize the way things can shift, you know?
No, he doesn't live here, that's for sure. You're right, Ricky. They're pretty heavy, you know, lads.
I think the man's made. I mean, if that happened to one of my kids, and he came round straight afterwards. I'll throw him straight over that bloody balcony.
Look, if it's really that dangerous, I don't think we should go in. I mean, we'll back you up. All we have to do is phone Ron at the union.
Oh, fuck, that won't do any good. I think it's down to you, Andy. It's your decision.
Thanks a million. Shit, I don't know, lads. Let's play it by you.
86, take 4.
Now, Teresa, could you try and tell me exactly what happened before Jacqueline was shot?
What happened was it? Jacqueline was by the side of the road with her friend, Deirdre. And the Brits came by, and their Saracen. And started shouting about their mates had been killed and all. And they turned away as they went past. Next minute, you know, there was a bang. And Jacqueline was lying on the side of the road.
Teresa, I must ask you this. Did you yourself see the shot fired?
No, not exactly, but I saw Jacqueline a minute before, and I saw the Brits driving off.
And what about the Army's statement that there was a riot at the time it happened?
There was no riot. The Brits are liars.
Regine, now if you could try and say soldiers instead of Brits, is that how you feel yourself, that the Army are liars?
Well, you know they are. I saw Jacqueline just before. She was wanting to watch. If she could have stayed, she'd still be alive.
Do you, Regine, blame me for what happened?
No. It's not what I meant. It could have been anyone. Soldiers did it.
What do you feel when soldiers are killed?
I just feel nothing, you know?
Do you think that it's a bad thing?
It doesn't make me feel any different. It doesn't do anybody good. I never does.
I don't see why we should feel sorry for the poor soldiers. The way they treat people. It's natural that people just try and hit back.
Regine, is that right, do you think, to always hit back?
Just try to keep out of trouble. So did Jacqueline. She always tried to keep out of the way. Just doesn't make any difference.
Regine, you've been very brave to talk about this. I don't want to make it any harder for you. But can you just tell me, finally, with all the terrible things that happen around you, and the things that you see every day, how does it make you feel?
What else can you do? I don't want to go around fighting all the time. Just keep hoping everything will get better. Just get on with it. Hope that it will.
You're going to use all that?
Well, that stuff about the shooting's pretty dodgy. I mean, without a reply from the Army, I've got no chance of getting him over there.
Well, you've coped with that sort of thing before, haven't you?
Yeah, another subject. You've no idea how sensitive they are over there about these things. I mean, the controller for Northern Ireland was on the phone to the hotel as soon as he knew we'd taken film of it.
Well, the Lamberg and Gessler of current affairs. Bring out his big stick, did he?
Oh, no, he didn't have to. Just asked me to be sure to get the Army's point of view, which I would have done anyway. I mean, it's the form.
Yeah, well, I suppose that's fair enough, isn't it?
Ah, it's a bugger. And that older girl's coming out with things that could lose us sympathy for the whole of the shooting.
Is it tea time, Cheryl?
And Larry. Yeah? Okay, well, what exactly is the problem now? Come on, they can't be reading out that old argument again, can they?
Bit my finger!
Yeah, I know it's sensitive. I was over there for Christ's sake. Now, Larry, you can't say something didn't happen when you got a film of it. It's perfectly adequate. Well, where do you think she got it from, eh? You're not saying the woman carried a spare plastic bullet around in her handbag, are you? It could not have been caused by a rock, Larry. There's a coroner's report.
Give night these leaflets about the protest meeting on Friday night. I suppose you heard about it.
I did, yes, sir.
Aye, well, it's publicised May Jacqueline's murder and everything that's been happening, which is, you know, amounts to nothing.
I'll tell you what to do. Give me a couple of leaflets and I'll put them round the doors here in this balcony.
God, that would be great.
Aye.
Get on. Save me a bit anyway.
Well, how are you feeling yourself?
I'm all right. At the end, I'm a teller, to tell you the truth, Kelly. Don't know where I'm coming or going.
Did you go to the doctor?
Aye.
Did he give you anything?
Aye, sleeping pills. Sure, I'm just bumping them into me whenever I can't face straight. It's like I'm walking about like a zombie half the times. Tell you the truth, like, Kelly, the only thing that seems to keep me going from day to day is knowing that our Jacqueline's death's one they're not going to get away with this time.
Well, you know we'll help you all we can. But you'll not bring Jacqueline back by putting yourself into an early grave.
I know, Kelly. Thanks. You know what I wanted to ask you? Do you remember that TV crew came to interview you, Roisin and Teresa?
Aye.
Do you think anything will come of that?
I don't know. Like, they were told the truth, but what they do about it's another thing. You know what these people are.
Yeah, I suppose so. They didn't come to see me anyway, I know that much.
Listen, what about coming out some night next week for a wee drink?
I wouldn't mind.
Should lift her mind for you.
Aye, maybe so.
What about a freeze frame? Oh, jeez, that's not good, Alex. I need it faster than that. Well, of course he's urgent. Well, I mean, we haven't got a TX date yet, OK, but, I mean, the series starts next week and there's every likelihood we'll go out two or three, isn't there? Oh, go on, Alex. I'll buy you a big drink next time I see you, if you can speed it up. Tuesday. Ah, oh, terrific, mate. I smash it. OK, I'll see you. Cheers.
Television, and let the people know what they're doing over here to our children.
Just try to keep out of trouble.
Correct it.
Then you wind it back.
Sure.
The trouble is, whichever way we cut this bit, it's dynamite.
Well, that's what you wanted, isn't it? Well, it is what you wanted, isn't it, Simon?
Well, it's what happened.
We're 2 minutes 57 over.
Well, the whole film?
Yeah.
Shit.
We could take some out of the inspector, what's it? And a bit out of the school, that's looking a bit loose.
No, it flows very well. Now it's the shooting bit that's jagged.
Well, that's forced to happen if you're going to use Verite material. Well, that regime stuff's really strong.
Can we look through it again? Sorry.
Sure.
Was it Jack and his by the side of the road? Or a friend? Deirdre? And the Brits came by? They're sorry.
You get rid of this voiceover. It'll save us 25 seconds.
Start with their mates have been
You've already got rid of a picture.
Have we?
Yeah.
And they turned away as they went past.
There was a chance to lose the patrol. That means we don't point the finger too strongly at the army. I mean, Teresa didn't actually see the shot fired.
That's a plastic bullet.
Then you got a little girl and a hysterical woman and no reply from the army. What do you do?
Show on your British television and let the people know what they're doing over here to our children.
Just try to keep
hold it there.
So, what you're trying to say is that that whole sequence has to come out, yeah?
Have to, won't we?
It's your decision.
I'll try it.
Well, if that's what you want. Yeah, get rid of it.
Television, and let the people know what they're doing.
I mean, it's all right, but it's in the wrong film. It sticks out like a sore thumb. Kind of 45 minutes of well-researched documentary and then slap them in the face with sensationalism, can you? It's cheap. I mean, it's all people remember. And the rest of the film might go stuff itself. Yeah, we're right to cut it. I'll just dream up a bit of commentary for it. Get us through the link. Are you there? Yeah. All right, stop at the church.
That's it. I'll try this new commentary.
Okay.
A few days after this film was taken, Regine's little friend Jacqueline was dead, shot by a plastic bullet. The army claimed there was a riot at the time. The local people say it was murder.
Just try to keep out of the trouble. So did Jacqueline. Shall we just try to keep out of the
way? I need something else, but that'll do.
She's my sister. I'm Teresa.
Yeah.
Well, when's it going to be on then?
I don't know. We finished it ages ago. Christmas, probably. If you're lucky.
Maybe Gracie and I can come along to your club sometime.
Certainly, Inspector Davidson of the Royal Ulster Constabulary has long lost his sentimentality about children.
Some of these children learn to throw a stone before they can walk. Now, these streets are where the vehicles are dumped, as an invitation to us, you might say. Now, when we came to take the vehicles out, those kids, just like the one you see here, seemed to have whole stores of missiles ready for us. Petrol bombs, rocks, iron bars, blast bombs. We get the lot thrown at us. Now, in the really hard rioting, you can see how they're put up to it by the adults. You can actually watch adults standing in the background, handing out petrol bombs and teaching them how to throw them. Now, those kids, from that point of view, never stand a chance. Either they're up against us, or they'd be in trouble with their so-called betters and elders behind them.
Yet if children have the ancient enmities of their elders to contend with, what shines through even the worst tragedies is that they still have minds and aspirations of their own.
Whatever you do doesn't mean to say you'd rather do it, you know. I know, but an empty flat may make a good game for a while, but I'd love to have a garden, you know, to play in. I'd look after it so well.
A few days after this film was taken, Regine's little friend Jacqueline was dead, shot by a plastic bullet. The army claim there was a riot at the time. The local people say it was murder.
Regine, you've been very brave to talk about this, so I don't want to make it any harder for you. But can you just tell me finally, with all the terrible things that happen around you and the things you see every day, how does it make you feel?
Just try to keep out of trouble. So does Jacqueline. She always try to keep out of the way. It just doesn't make any difference.
As time and again the rights and wrongs of the situation founder on the realities of extremism, Regine's words echo the hopes of many.
What else can you do? I don't want to go around fighting all the time. Just keep hoping everything will get better. Just get on with it. Hope that it will.
Some lights, Shirley.
Awful. Just awful. I don't know when I've been so moved by a documentary film. That awful, devastated place. I don't know how, but I think you've got a chemistry there. A kind of tragic poetry.
Yes, it is tragic, isn't it?
Oh, it's dreadful. And that little girl.
Regine.
Well, how'd you get her to talk so soon? So soon after...
Well, I think Sue must take the credit for that.
Well, I'm impressed. That was a terrible situation to get into. But you handled it very steadily. And come up with... Well, the only problem I can see is one of length.
Yes, but I was hoping for another 5 minutes. I mean, we can trim a few bits in the middle, but we're a bit squeezed on one or the others.
Yes, I sense that in places. Do what I can for you. I think I could fight for this one. But there's no chance of more than 5 minutes, I can tell you that now.
Right, thanks.
Well, I have a meeting upstairs now, unfortunately, so I'll have to leave it at that for the moment. The only other thing to watch, I mean, it's wonderful how you've got the emotion there. But we don't want to fall into emotionalism, if you know what I mean.
Yes, yes, I do.
His wife keeps phoning.
You're right for drink, aren't you?
Now she just.
Oh, hey. Ciao.
There you go.
I think this calls for cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Well done.
So we got away with it then, Simon?
Yeah, he loved it. He's an emotional guy, but he's not sentimental. You see what he does to rabbits.
What's all that about rabbits?
Well, Lawrence.
You realise that you have butchered the Rasheen interview, don't you?
Come on, Sue. Look, Teresa didn't see that incident any more than we did. So everything she said had to go. I think Regine comes out of it very strongly.
Oh, yeah. Very strong. And totally meaningless.
How the hell can you say that? Look, this film has got Ulster kids talking in their own words for the entire 50 minutes. You haven't had to fight as hard as I have for what's been kept.
Look, we had a responsibility to those people. Can't you see that? I mean, can't you see that what you have kept won't change anything?
Look, if I thought it was my responsibility to change things, I wouldn't finish a bloody film. If you feel that strongly about it, why didn't you say so to Lawrence when he was there and I was giving you credit?
Well, I could hardly say anything. I don't know them.
Look, I've stuck up for you all the way through this. Because you've done your job. But what the hell you think you've been doing, Christ.
Yes, but you know what you've been doing, don't you? You know exactly what you've been doing.
So whose programme is it anyway? Well, if he's going to be out front, who's going to take the rap, you or him?
Well, listen, I made that film as well, you know.
All right. If you think your work's been distorted, you can take your name off the credits. Now, come on, love. You make your mind up whether you want to be a television documentary maker or a friggin' social worker.
Okay, look, come on, Sue. We know it was a wonderful piece of work. We're all really proud of what we've done.
Well, I think we know where we all stand here, don't we?
For Brandy, you know, will you?
We'll just call this a professional disagreement, then, shall we?
Call it what you bloody like.
Look, come on, Sue. Have another drink. I think we all need one, don't you, after all of that?
Look, I better be off, but I'm sorry I raised my voice, so, you know, I think I've been a bit tired, really. But,
Scotch there.
I'll see you later, then.
What was all that about?
Liberal conscience, played by Sue McKenna.
Oh, let's leave it alone, shall we? Yeah, stick a white one.
It's not so long ago that scenes like this were a regular feature at Divis Flats. The ritual manoeuvres of troops, armoured cars and rioters made a grimly familiar entertainment. All these ingredients combined to make Divis a breeding ground for paramilitaries. Nowadays it's quieter, but boarded up windows remain like scars in the Divis landscape, a reminder of its troubled past. The children browse through rubble and toy with abandoned cars. They say there's nothing to do. At first glance, they don't seem to take it as seriously as the parents, who know more sharply what conditions mean. A burning in the Divis Flats can seem like a bonfire in any backyard in Britain, a youthful release from boredom, bad housing, and neglect. Yet beneath the casual stone-throwing lie frustration and defiance. This is no children's game. Can I just take a sip of water, though? I'm a bit dry.
Right, rewind. Okay, thanks very much, Ralph. Very good. How the hell did you do it, eh?
Sheer dedication and talent, my friend.
Yeah, well, we'll drink to that in half an hour, right?
Hey, you managed to make it sound as if you really love the place, Ralphie.
Not bloody likely. That's where they should put those cruise missiles. Stick them all in Northern Ireland. Get the gum chewers to start a war with the bear shaggers, and boom, end of problem.
See on about.
Been offensive to Russians.
Sounds a very English solution, Ralph. Thank you very much.
There isn't a solution, is there? Not with people like that around.
Okay, we'll have a listen to it again. Just relax.
Oh, Sue.
I never did manage to congratulate you personally for your research on the Ulster film. It's turned out really well. Possibly the best of the series. And you obviously made your own contribution to that.
Oh, well, thank you.
What are you working on now?
Oh, I've been researching a programme on Brick Lane, you know, these last few weeks.
Brick Lane?
Yes, it's been absolutely fascinating. The people are really interesting there. It's a large Asian community, you know, in the East End of London.
You do get the meaty subjects, don't you? But that's good for you. More of those you do, the faster you'll learn.
Well, as long as I get the chance, you know, this is my last project before my contract runs out.
Well, we'll just have to see what we can do, won't we?
Oh, thank you.
As time and again,
Rushing.
The rights and values of the situation founder on the realities of extremism, Rushin's words echo the hopes of many.
What else can you do? I don't want to go around fighting all the time. Just keep hoping everything will get better. Just get on with it. Hope that it will.
Is that it? All that for just a couple of minutes? And trees are not even in it?
It's as if they never said a word.
And next week, Britain's Children visits a commune in Glastonbury and examines the...
Well, we'll remind you. One footage on radio stays on the air.
Okay, John, there you are. Thanks.
2 a.m. We'll be back tomorrow morning at 9:25 for the look at the day ahead. I hope you join us for Saturday's programme. Until tomorrow, this is Keith Hayes saying...
Come on there, boys, drink up. It's after 12 o'clock. We were here at 3 o'clock this morning.
I'm going to go to the hospital. 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 I'm going to go